First of all, can you introduce us or give us some idea about what's your job in Cubizone?
I'm Ryan Maldosa. I'm currently the product manager for Yulgang 2. I started on the project just last month. So hopefully we'll have a successful launch this by the end of the year. Yulgang 2 was initially announced in South Korea last 2010. It started its OBT in Korea just January. So right now we're gonna release the first English client of Yulgang 2 in Southeast Asia. So we're expecting players not just from Southeast Asia but also from North America, from Europe, since this is the first English client of the game. The game is a 3D martial arts game. It's a faction-based non-targeting action MMORPG. Similar to other MMORPGs like Blade & Soul, Terra Online, C9. I think Yulgang 2 can keep up with those popular MMORPGs in terms of gameplay and PvP content. Based on the videos from Blade & Soul, I think it's quite similar. But Yulgang 2 is based from separate Korean manhwa, the comics. So the air sprint, the skills are not really that, we're not copied from Blade & Soul. It's really based from its own Korean manhwa.
Thank you. So, can you describe what is the setting and world like in Yulgang 2?
Yulgang 2, it's an open world MMORPG. So basically, players, it also has instance dungeons and instance PvP dungeons. So players can have an open option to grind in the open field or on instance dungeons. They can also have an option for PvP in the open field. We have open maps for PK, and we have also instance dungeons for PvP.
So, can you give us some idea on what makes this game unique from other MMORPG that you played or you've handled before?
Maybe you have already watched our videos. We're promoting the air sprint. You see on all of our videos. It's really the selling point. It's a unique part of the game, the air sprint system of the game.
Yeah.
And also, if you have watched yesterday our free play, you could see the skill combos of the game were really unique.
Yeah, so, what kind of the progression system can player expect in the game? So, will players get stat points, skill points, or something else that they can level?
The progression points of the game is the skills. So each player can receive a unique tomb. The tomb contains a separate skill set. So players, when they reach the max level, they could have 2 to 3 skill tombs. In each tombs, there are 5 skills. So they could switch tombs during PvP. So they could combine different skill combos.
Are they going to get some XP on arena or PvP zone?
We're still planning with what type of achievement system for the PvP, but we're looking on giving rewards to players when they join the arena PvP.
Okay. So how will players differentiate themselves from other characters in the game? So how am I going to be unique if I'm going to play this game?
The game has a simple but detailed character customization. So the players could, from the character sizes to the facial features to the headgear, I think based on that, players could show how unique are them from the other players. And also, the game has like I said before, has different skill tombs. So players can select this tomb and they could use these combos to make them popular in the game.
Okay, so what do you think the most exciting features in Yulgang 2? So you are gonna be going to be excited.
I think the most exciting feature of the game is the faction war, besides the air sprint, of course. We haven't yet featured the faction war in our videos, but during our OBT launch, we're gonna emphasize our promotions on the faction war.
Can you tell us some idea regarding this game?
Right now, I'm still not allowed to give
out. Okay, that, no problem.
But it's quite massive. The faction war of the game, the faction system, faction war system of it is really massive. So both players from both factions really gonna meet up to fight for supremacy.
So how will Yulgang 2 handle PvP? Will there be a smaller arenas or battlegrounds player can fight on?
Like I've said before, the PvP content of the game is really massive. We have the arena, the faction war, we have guild wars, we have instance dungeon PvP, we have PK map PvP, but we're not gonna release that gradually in the game. So players can expect a lot from the game.
So I'm also looking forward for the launching of this game.